In the last few years, there's been a lot of attention paid in the popular press and popular media to lists of things. A good example of this has been the EWG list of the Dirty Dozen, where they've taken surveys from government sources of fruits and vegetables and then simply listed them in an kind of a hierarchical order, saying, well, this plant or this food product, this fruit, this vegetable has a higher pesticide residue than this one. And then the implication is drawn. And it's perfectly logical to a consumer who's not skilled in this area, you'd say, well, if it's the highest, it must represent something that's bad. What's missing from this equation, though, is what amount actually represents a risk. And if you don't factor that into it, you can be somewhat capricious or arbitrary and say, well, I'm not going to eat that apple or that strawberry or that walnut because it has a level of a pesticide there. The reality is most plants have some low level of pesticide residue, some of them from compounds we haven't used in 20 years. But it doesn't necessarily mean it represents any risk whatsoever. So that's really problematic. We have to somehow help educate the consumer about this.